Hello everybody, this is my presentation on implementing system version temporal table. It includes everything about system version temporal table, starting from what it is up to its implementation. If anyone wanted to have this slide, I upload it to my PGCon account, so it is available on conference website. First, if you think about me, my name is Surafil Tamaskan. Currently, I'm working as a DBA. I also have work experience on full stack web application development. And starting from the last 1 or 2 years, I'm participating on PostgreSQL development. My latest contribution is adding WizTy option to fetch first clause, which is on PostgreSQL 13, and that can be found on Twitter at specified address on the screen. But I didn't tweet much yet. In this presentation, first, we will see the definition of system version temporal table and how it differs from other temporal table kind. And then we will see the application of it. In PostgreSQL, we have at least two options to implement a system version table. One is using two tables for storing, one for current data and other one for history data. Other alternative is using one table for storing both current and history record. I will talk about both options and the advantage of implementing it using one table approach. Finally, we will talk about new syntax and their function that system version temporal table will introduce. System version temporal table is introduced to SQL standard along with the application time period and other temporal specification in 2011 release. It is about the retention of deleted record along with the current one automatically by database management system, and the ability of querying both current and history record. And there are application time period, which are for meeting business model, having time varying information, and it is managed by user rather than by database system. And it is legal to have both system version and the application time period in a single table. We can use the system version temporal table for the sake of easily recovering from accidental data modification. If we enable system versioning to the table, you can go back to any time point, to any point in time using a SQL query. We can also use it for auditing to check how things look like in the past. And other interesting use cases to model reality in place of application time period. If model reality change at the same times with the database modification, we can use system version temporal table because it have the advantage of maintaining by the system automatically. We can also use it to analyze how things look like over time. In PostgreSQL, we have at least two designs for implementing implement system version temporal table. One is on wiki page that describe implementing using two tables, one for history data and the other for current data. But I don't go with this approach because I don't know why I should in most part. Rather, I propose to implement it using only one table for storing both current and history record, and it is on current commit first. I will talk about both approach and I describe more on my approach and its advantage. Two table approach involves two tables, one for current data storage and the other for history data. One big advantage of this approach is non-temporal query, which are the frequent query performance didn't affect by history data because it's only access current table. But nowadays you can achieve similar performance by partitioning, and in this approach all the record generated by delete and update operation inserted to history table using a trigger, and multiple column have to create implicitly to make correlation between current and history record. In one table approach, both current and history data stores in one table. It uses end time column and value to classify the record. If the value is infinity, it is current record. Otherwise, it's deleted at a specified time in a row in the time column. And system version the table treats like a kind of generated column in its implementation because the syntax is similar, and generated column passed the test of time, and the result of non-temporal query doesn't have to include or consider history record. So filter calls will be added to such kind of query implicitly. There are two create system version table. There are two options to create system version table. If it is okay to use default system version in column names, just adding with system version in keyword at the end of table definition is enough. It enables system versioning with the default system version in column name. But if you wanted to use different name for system version in column, we have to use extended option as specified on the screen. Stay two timestamp with time zone columns with generated always as row start and end time specification. In my implementation, both current and history data stores in one table, but it's perfectly legal to have multiple record having the same primary and unique key value in the past. the constraint only have to be observed on current data or current records, and in order to allow this happen, row in the time column is added to primary and unique key constraint implicitly, because in current record, row in the time column value is always infinity. So that force primary and unique key value to be unique across current record. But in history record, row in the time column value is different. So primary and unique key value can be repeated. In that system varying column set automatically, row start time will be set to current transaction time, and row end time column will be set to infinity. Here there are opinion on the appropriateness of setting row end time column value to infinity. If we take this value literally, it means row will be current until infinity. But it's not true. The record will be removed sometimes before infinity. More meaningful values to store variable now, which have the meaning data is current until now. But which I think it is more appropriate value. But storable now variable didn't exist. So even SQL standard state to use longest date data type value. In PostgreSQL, it is infinity. Normally, update didn't occur in place. So it's performed by marking the tuple to be update to delete. That can be actually removed by other process, and then insert the updated tuple into the table. But for a system version temporal table implementation, delete to tuple will be inserted back with the row in the time column value set to current transaction time. That make the record history record, and inserts updated tuple by making it current record by setting row start time column value to current transaction time, and in the time column value to infinity. In delete, the record didn't actually removed. Instead, it's inserted back with the row in the time column value set to current transaction time. That in the record being current record. In select, non-temporal query should not incorporate or consider history record. So history data filter clause added to it implicitly. Advantage of one table approach. Alter table is not any complex than non-temporal table alter operation. But in two table approach, modification in current table should have to propagate to history table, and other advantages. There is no need of technical column to correlate between history and current data. And if we support in-place updates for marking deleted tuple as history data, we can enjoy many optimization because there will be no need of vacuum except for freezing, and the data will be stored sorted by row start and in the time column automatically, so we can harness multiple optimization for temporal query processing on this behavior. The first form of temporal queries for system time as-of clause. It is used when there is a need to see the table at specified point in time in the past. It returns all the record current at specified point in time, which means column value less than specified point in time end, which means row start time column value less than specified point in time, and row end time column value greater or equal to specified point in time value will be returned, and the syntax is specified on the screen. And the other form is from clause, which return all the record current within specified time range, including time point 1, but excluding time point 2. Between clauses, it is the same as from clause, except it includes the record current at point time point 2, so it's the only difference from clauses. It's include in the time point 2 to its return value. Between asymmetric clauses, the same as between symmetric or between clause, it's just more descriptive. And between symmetric clause, here the order of time point specification is not matter, because it works by picking the least time point and return record up to and including the greater time point. There are a new syntax introduced to enable system versioning to existing table, which is alter table add system versioning. It uses default system versioning column name, and if the table contain data, it will be marked to current data by setting row start time column value to current transaction time and row end time column value to infinity. If we want to use different column name for system versioning, we can do it by issuing add column statement to row start and end time column with the desired column name in one command, as seen on the screen. But it is forbidden to issue add column command separately because it leaves system versioning in unusable state. if we wanted to, if we don't want system versioning no more, or if we want to delete history data up to now, we can issue drop system versioning to the table. That drops system versioning column along with history data. We can use it with add system versioning command to limit the growth of system version table. And here are other alternative command to disable system versioning. So if anyone wanted to look at the patch and review, it is on current commit feast. Please review if possible. Thanks.